Hindi pa natatapos ang sakuna pero napakalaki na po ng pinsalang na itatala sa agrikultura, nasa estimated 75 million para sa probinsya ng Batangas at ng Cavite. Meron daw pa utang ang DA tsaka ang Department of Trade and Industry, pero ang tanong nga ng iba, bakit pa utang? Hindi ba dapat financial aid sa ganitong mga panahon ng sakuna? Ano ang assessment mo dito, Richard?
Mukhang atom, no, yung sakop, no, nung pinsala, no, yung damage is so large na siguro ang dapat pag-usapan natin dito is a combination of aid, no, para tumulong sa mga communities to get over the crisis, to cope with it. Pero siguro in the long term, we're talking about the complete reconstruction and redevelopment plan. At dito, dapat pinag-usapan siguro even loans, no, as a potential way forward. Kasi of course, limited din yung resources ng government. But this is again, in terms of helping them to cope with the crisis. Pero yung long-term reconstruction and development plan could be in terms of, you know, hundreds of millions of dollars, no, ang pinag-usapan dito. Kasi ang laki ng sakop, no. Which brings us to the second issue. Mukhang kailangan din natin ng major bureaucratic reform. At ang proposal ngayon, which sa ngayon ako dyan, is perhaps we should fast track ngayon yung pag-establish ng Department of Disaster Resilience. Matagal na pinag-usapan yan, Atom, no? At ang idea dito is, as much as we have interagency task force and other kind of mechanisms to deal with it, dahil ang Pilipinas, according to studies, so multiple studies, Atom, is among top 10 most vulnerable countries to natural disasters and environmental crisis. And yung isang reason ng vulnerability natin is also lack of, you know, bureaucratic mechanisms to deal with it effectively, then siguro we need a specialized department to deal with it. At ang pwedeng gawin ng department na yan, among other things, is first of all, siguro atong kailangan ng time for no-build zone. No? Kung may no-fly zone when you have volcanic disruption, siguro kailangan din ng no-build zone. The other thing is to create permanent evacuation centers. Ang problema natin ngayon is marami tayong mga temporary evacuation. Right. I think 50,000 people have been squeezed into like 200 temporary evacuation centers. So you need all of that put in place. No? Pero lastly, atong, no, my concern also is this. Huwag natin kalimutan yung other reconstruction na hindi pa naayos, including yung sa Marawi, no? Which is still, for me, no, based on what nakikita natin, it's still a big disaster.
Di ba, nabawasan nga yung ating calamity fund. So, even if we have a Department of Disaster Risk Reduction, there has to be a clear priority na papondohan natin yung ganitong klaseng resilience. Kasi hindi lang naman panahon ng sakuna eh.
Right.
Yung it's really before something happens that we have to be prepared.
Right, the preparation, including yung no-build zone. No? And of course, once you create a new department, hindi pinag-usapan dito, 2 billion, 7 billion, or 16 billion na calamity fund, we're gonna talk about the real budget for a real department. Dahil ang problema natin dito is huge. And we have to have corresponding bureaucratic response to that. And yung budget na kailangan, not only for coping with disasters, but long-term reconstruction and redevelopment.